If you want to present a web view inside a SwiftUI app, well, if you do want to do it natively, well, you're kind of out of luck because SwiftUI doesn't support that just yet. We don't have a kind of view, a web view inside SwiftUI 2.0 right now, but we can leverage UIKit. And that is where this tutorial comes in handy. Today, I'm going to show you how you can present a web view inside a SwiftUI app. Alex here from Rebeloper. Open up Xcode, hit that subscribe button, and let's jump in. Showing a web view in your iOS app may be critical. You want to show a web page or your site, but you don't really know how to. And on top of that, you want to do this on a SwiftUI app. Well, today we are going to learn just that. We are going to do that with just simple lines of code. I have prepared everything for you, so go ahead and stay tuned to the end of the tutorial. So, yeah, in SwiftUI, how can you add the web view in a SwiftUI? In UIKit, we have something called WKWebView. And you just call that and you can have a web view inside your app. So you are not navigating away into Safari or Google Chrome or whatever other browser you have on your device, but you are showing the web view inside your app. And that's a good thing because you want to keep your users inside your app. So today we are going to do that in a SwiftUI app. We are going to use WKVIEW. But before we jump into that, let me just remind you about DevFactory, my mentoring that you can use for learning or trying out new stuff or bug fixing. It is a Zoom call. Go ahead and check it out, rebeloper.com/mentoring. Okay, so let's dive into this. We are going to use WKVIEW, a GitHub repository that I have created. You can add it as an SPM, a Swift package manager. Okay, so down you will see the links for the resources, basically the default project, so the starter project. And I have just created this starter project. It's called WKVIEW Demo. And it's a SwiftUI app. And all I have changed is the content view. And let me just go through it real quick. Because one thing to note here with web views, you want to have the navigation bar right on top. So you want to have this web view inside our navigation view. But most probably your app has this navigation view. So all I have here is a vertical stack with a divider. I will add in here a navigation link. And then we have a button and the spacer that pushes that all of the way up. We have a navigation bar title and we are setting the navigation bar title display mode to inline. You can leave it as large if you wanted to, but on the web view, we have this as inline. Okay, so let's just jump right into it. And what we have to do is just go ahead and check out the GitHub repository. Of course, you can take a look at the README file if you want to, but yeah, this is video, so it's much more easier. Go ahead and select HTTPS and copy that out. Let's move back to Xcode and navigate to our project, Swift Packages, and click on the plus sign here. Paste that URL in there. Let's click on next there. It's verifying. Current version is 0.05, but it might be larger if you are taking a look at this in the future, which you are probably. So what we are going to do is present this web view inside the navigation. And I'm also going to show you how you can present it inside a sheet, because maybe you want to pop it up as a sheet. So let's click on finish here and let's go back to our content view and let's have a little bit more space here. Okay, so push a web view with a URL. So the URL will be rebeloper.com, so HTTPS rebeloper.com. So what I'm going to do is just simply, I'm going to add a navigation link here. Now, usually you are going to present these web views by a touch of a button or something like that. So I just figured navigation link will do. So navigation link, there we go. And I'm just going to use the one with the title and the destination. Okay, the title push web view. And here is the destination. So let me just delete this. Now this will needs to be a view. Before we can kind of initialize the web view, we want to import WKVIEW. So let's just import WKVIEW. Okay, so now we have access to WebView. So WebView, there it is. And as you can see, there are two types here with the URL and a bunch of other stuff. We will get to that soon. So for now, let's just go with the URL. And let's just type in here https rebeloper.com. Okay, and basically that's it. Let's just build and run this and see that, of course, we are in a navigation view, so we will be able to slide, or rather push, this web view in. Okay, it's building really, really nice. Now, the next part, we will just present this on a slide sheet. Okay, so push web view. There it is. It says loading, and we have this nice HUD here, and we have the refresh button, we have the back button, and here at the toolbar, at the bottom toolbar, we have a forward button and a back, or a, yeah, it's going back button. So let me just show you how that works. First of all, let's refresh. As you can see, it's loading, it's refreshing. Yeah, by the way, go ahead and check out Dev Factory, rebeloper.com/mentoring. Okay, so let's just go and apply now, and we will be taken to rebeloper.com/mentoring. And yeah, if we wanted to, we can just go back by clicking on the back button here. And now that we do have something to go forward to, some new page to go forward to, we can just go forward. If I just tapped on this next, then it will not go back. Okay, so yeah, what about the back button? Well, we can just pop this view back to our like container view. Okay, so that's that. If we present the web view, currently it's just an empty sheet. So let's take care of that next. Okay, let me just copy this out and just paste it in there. As you can see, I'm having also a navigation view because, yeah, the sheet is just a simple view, but because we do need the title, the navigation bar there, we are presenting the web view inside a navigation view. So let's build and run and see what's happening here. And yeah, you could, yeah, let me just tap on this. There we go. It's the same thing. It's just pushing it up. And if we wanted to, we can just slide down. Let me just slide down all together. There we go. Let's present the web view again. And if we just tapped on the back, we can just dismiss that. But we can also remove the back button if we wanted to. So in this example, so at this stage, I will just use one of those properties, and it is hides back button. I will set this to true. By default, it's set to false. So it is not hiding the back button. So let's just build and run again. And now you will not see the back button, basically. Let's present the web view. And yeah, there we go. It's not even there, so we can just slide this down. In some cases, you might want to use this one. Of course, do not hide the back button when you are presenting it, when you are pushing it on the navigation stack. Okay, so let me just remove this. And finally, let's talk about all of those customizable stuff because it's looking really great. So I would just start typing in web view. And this time around, let's use this long initializer. So the URL string will be the same. So let me just copy that out. Now let's talk about the next one, tint color. The tint color will basically tint the web view. That means that we are going to tint the back text, the refresh button, and also down at the toolbar, the bottom toolbar, the going back and going forward buttons. So let's have this as red, maybe. Titled color. Now the title color is the title color that we are going to use. Let's have here yellow, maybe. Of course, you could just style this. And by the way, this is going to change its background color according to the appearance of the current device, be it light or dark. So that looks really nice. Most probably I will show you this. So next up we have back text. Now we have currently on the back button, it says back. Now let's just call it console or whatever you want it. It is a text, so let's use text and console, and let's make it italic. Okay, so yeah, you can style this text. Next up we have hides back button. So I don't want to hide the back button for now, so I will just remove it. So yeah, this is how you can just remove any element that you don't really want. Now we have the reload image, that is the refresh button basically, go forward image, and the go back image. And I will just copy these out. These are images, so image, and let's go system image. You could use your own images if you wanted to, but I will just copy out these from here. I have them pasted here. So this is a figure with this waving, that is the reload. And I'm just going to change the forward. So again, image. Oh, I'm typing in the wrong place. So let's select this image. There we go. System. And paste that in here. So it's forward frame fail. Yeah, you could just do whatever image you'd like here. And finally, let's just go with backward frame fill. There we go. And those are the customizations. So let's just build and run and see this in light mode. Now, after that, I will change to dark mode and see how that looks. So present web view. Really nice. As you can see, this is the italics back button, which says console now. The developer, it's yellow. We have this waving character and going forward and going back. Okay, let's just stop this. And let me just go ahead and go into developer and dark appearance. And let's build and run again. And now we will see the dark mode presentation. So push web view, really nice. This is the default value. As you can see, Rebeloper has changed from black tint color to light, so like white. Let's go back now, present the web view, and really, really nice. As you can see, this is kind of a darkish navigation bar background and toolbar background. Now that is that simple to just add a web view on your SwiftUI apps. Go ahead and check out the GitHub repository. Let me just go there. It is github.com/developer/WKVIEW. Go ahead and give it a star if you did like it. Or maybe watch it also when I do some changes. And while you are there, go ahead and check out Dev Factory. I mentor you on a Zoom call. So that is it for today. So now you have a clean and easy way to add web views into your SwiftUI apps. Now I am curious, what would you like to see next? What tutorial should I make next? Go ahead and leave your ideas down in the comments section. And while you do that, make sure to smash that notification bell to get notified of those new videos as they come out. Now, while you are waiting for those new videos, make sure to check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about Swift, SwiftUI in general, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.